On the 24th of April 1915, a group of Armenian intellectuals was rounded up in Istanbul and murdered. It marked the beginning of the Ottoman government's systematic removal of the Armenian minority from their historic homeland.
Soykırım demek böyle bir boş soykırım değildir. İnsanları diri diri kiliseye sokmuşlar, insanları diri diri ahıra sokmuşlar, diri diri yakmışlar.
I'm Lara Petrossian. My family was one of the few to escape. I've come to Turkey to see what remains of my Armenian roots.
I'm Rengin Arslan. I'm a Turkish journalist. And I want to know why we were not taught about this at school.
Sizin görüşünüz soykırım olmadığı.
Kesinlikle bu yani bir tehcir olayı var. Ama bu tehcir olayı kesinlikle soykırım değildir.
100 years on, Rengin and I are both setting out on personal journeys to explore whether Turkish society is ready to openly discuss its past. Rengin and I meet in the heart of Istanbul.
Allahu Isa.
Hello, Rengin.
How are you?
Welcome.
Finally,
you
met.
Yeah.
Thank
it's
you
great
so much.
Great to see
That's
you. Too.
Great to
we
see
have a lot
you.
To talk about.
Yeah.
So what are you planning to do here?
I've come to Turkey.
Welcome.
To trace my background. I'm going to Van and Muş. My great grandparents were from Van. If I can find anything about Armenians and the life in Van at that time, it's quite interesting for me. So what are you going to do?
I think I'm going to Eskişehir. It's my hometown. There were Armenians before 1915. I just want to learn more about what happened to them. I just need to
discover for yourself.
Yeah, discover, yeah. Mm.
So here's a good trip. It's a great journey.
Great journey.
I have always known that my family came from here, Anatolia, eastern Turkey. Armenians lived around the shores of Lake Van for nearly 2,000 years. I want to find out what now remains of the Armenians and their culture. My journey begins on Akhtamar Island, site of the famous Church of the Holy Cross. It once stood at the center of an ancient Armenian kingdom. I'm meeting a local guide.
Can I help you?
Thank you. Hello, I'm Lara.
Hi. I'm Engin.
Very nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you too.
Engin, the beauty of this place is just breathtaking. The lake, the mountains, and then the church.
Look, when you're coming here, you feel different, I think.
What was the importance of the church for Armenians living around here?
Because it is the most beautiful church in Armenian arts.
This is one of the few Armenian churches that is still standing in Turkey today.
So whatever is here, the frescoes, all are original.
Yeah, yeah, all wow. Original.
Is this an active church?
It is not active church. Every September, 1 week, Armenian people can come here and they can pray here just for 1 week. But we hope every week. But we are not sure. There is no Armenian in Van. Maybe there are some Armenian, but they don't say we are Armenian. Maybe they are afraid to explain that we are Armenian.
My great grandparents were living in Van up until 1915.
Yeah.
And I'm always wondering if they would have come here to pray. Do you think they were coming here?
Yes, I am sure that all Armenians people before 1915 came here, because it was the religion center of Armenian.
It's a really strange feeling for me to know that my great-grandparents were coming here every Sunday.
Yes. Of course.
Maybe standing at the same place and praying.
I feel closer to them than ever.
Thank you. I'd be so grateful.
You're welcome.
The city of Van is home to about 500,000 people, but there is no sign that Armenians ever lived here.
Again, it was such an emotional journey for me, seeing the Holy Cross Church and knowing that maybe my great-grandparents were going there regularly to worship and pray. So I've brought some pictures to show you. This is my great-grandfather, Mihran Ayvazian. This is his wife, Armine, and these are their daughters. This is my grandmother. This picture was taken when they left in 1915 because of the killings. They went to Yerevan and then Iran. But I have another picture to show you. This picture was taken in 1908. This is my great-grandfather. This is the Association of Armenian Silversmiths. In Van, and he was one of them. So this is the lead. I want to go and search for him.
The next day, I meet Engin under the ramparts of the old citadel, which looks over the old part of the city.
So this is the old Armenian quarter?
Yes.
These are original streets?
This is original streets.
From 100 years ago?
And look, the stone, all stones are original.
This was part of the Armenian quarters, and Armenians were walking here.
Yes. And that part, you know, front of us, those are all shops.
How interesting.
Yes.
So I might be walking on the footsteps of my great-grandparents here.
Yes.
This was where the silversmith shops were, yeah?
Those are all silver shops.
And nothing has left of them.
Yeah.
Just ruined. And my great-grandfather Mihran probably used to own one of these shops. When the killing started in 1915, they wanted to escape. He didn't even lock the door to his shop. He knew there was no coming back.
It's a big shock for you, I think, and for them also.
Yes, to see the place, the last place, before they left.
On the top of the
houses
and shops.
And how many Armenians lived here?
About 60,000.
The long-established Armenian community had begun to suffer discrimination and pogroms as the Ottoman Empire started to disintegrate at the turn of the 20th century. With the outbreak of the First World War in 1914, the very existence of the empire was under threat. Turkish nationalists, who controlled the Ottoman government, regarded the Armenians as a disloyal minority. They believed the Armenians wanted to side with their enemy, Russia, so the Ottoman government ordered mass deportations. Over 1.5 million men, women, and children were forcibly removed. The majority of them were either killed or died of starvation.
Crosses on the wall and some Armenian writing.
That Armenian people were living here.
Do people of Van know what happened here in 1915?
You know, they know what happened in 1915, but they don't want to talk about it.
But you think they knew that Armenians who were living here in this area were all killed?
Yeah.
You mean they know what happened, but it's difficult to talk about?
Yes.
They don't want to talk about, or they're fearful to talk about it?
They don't want to talk about. It's very, very big shock for people. When you look at the city, you don't see any places, you know. They were living here together, friendly, you know, neighbors.
There is nothing left of my family's neighborhood. No address to go to, no neighbors to talk to, nothing. It's like we never existed here.
Wow, look at all this jewelry. I'm thinking my great-grandfather sitting down and making silver stuff. I'm looking for any sort of Armenian signs or symbols.
There is still a thriving jewelry industry here, so there might be a link with my Armenian past.
My great-grandfather lived in here. Oh. Yes, up until 1915. I'm Armenian, yes. When they heard that the killings of Armenians started, they left. So I have a picture of the Armenian Silversmith Association.
Really?
And he was in it, yes. It's very, very, very exciting.
This was taken here?
Yes, this is the Association of Armenian Silversmiths. This picture was taken in 1908 in Van. Uh-huh. There was a big community of Armenian silversmiths here.
Mesela benim babamın asıl mesleği bakırcılık ve el işleri yapan farklı şeylerle uğraşmış. Daha sonradan işte biz sabat işine döndük.
O ustalar kimlerdi?
O ustalar da yine Van'ın eski yerli ustaları.
Yerli dedim,
Ermeni ustaları.
Ah, they were Armenian.
Do you know if any Armenian still lives in Van?
Var olması da bir şey değiştirmiyor çünkü herkes kendini artık şey yapmış, kapatmış yani. Şu anda görünen kimse göz.
They never heard what happened to the Armenians in Van.
O dönemde neler dönmüş, neler olmuş. Pek fazla bize pek kimse anlatmadı.
I'm watching what he's doing and I'm thinking of my great grandfather probably using the same tools.
Şu uç yaklaşık 110-120 yaşındadır.
This is the type of stuff that my great grandfather was making.
Şimdi mesela bunlar İsfahan işidir.
In all these years they've been doing this with the same type of tools and the skills were passed on.
Although I have not been able to trace any living relatives or any other Armenians, I was astounded to see their craftsmanship had survived by being handed down.
While Lara has been in eastern Turkey, I've come to my hometown of Eskişehir in central Turkey. It is a bustling university city. A center of learning. At 17, I left to study in Istanbul. It was only then that I learned there had been a large Armenian community in Eskişehir. I've come home to find out more about this hidden history. I start at a Turkish cultural center right in the heart of my city, which was once an Armenian church. A local Turkish historian, Kemal Yakut, is going to show me around.
Bu binanın önünden her geçişimde hüzünlenirim. 1915'te Ermeniler bu topraklardan atıldıktan sonra bu bina önce kaderine terk edilmiş. Mülkiyeti çok el değiştirmiş. Daha sonra 1945 yılında bir sinemaya dönüştürülüyor. Hmm. Maalesef başlangıçta kültür ya da tematik filmler oynatılırken 1970'lerde, 1980'lerde erotik filmlerin de gösterildiği bir yere dönüştü. Orijinal halinden yalnızca bu kubbe kalmış durumda.
Burada siz peki çocukluğunuzda biliyor muydunuz? Onu çok merak ediyorum. Ben bilmiyordum burada bir kilise olmuş olduğunu. Bu binanın daha önce bir kilise olduğunu bilmiyordum.
Ben de açıkçası çocukluğumda, gençliğimde buranın bir kilise olduğunu bilmiyordum. Hep zihnimde bir sinema olduğu konusunda. Fakat ben de çok bir 8-9 yıl önce buranın eskiden bir kilise olduğunu öğrendim. Hatta bir fotoğrafına ulaşmaya çalıştım. Şu kilise dışarıdan görünüşü.
Dolayısıyla bütün bu çerçevesi sonradan çok değişmiş.
Kesin, evet.
Öyle değil mi?
Binanın ön yüzü özellikle çok değişmiş.
Neden Eskişehir'deki veya Türkiye'deki Ermeni tarihini bilmiyorduk ve bu bize neden öğretilmedi?
Şimdi bu yalnızca Eskişehir'in meselesi değildi. Bu Türkiye'nin aslında büyük bir meselesiydi. Tabii bir ulus devlet kurulmaya çalışıldı. Bunun Türkleştirme projesinin kültür alanında, eğitim alanında, iktisat alanında, bütün alanlarda açıkçası şey yapıldı. Bunlar hepsi bir kenara itildi ve bizim hafızalarımızdan çıkartıldı. Çünkü bir milli tarih inşa edilmeye çalışıldı. Eskişehir'in kültürel hayatı da Ermeniler tarafından canlandırılıyor. İlk tiyatro topluluğu Eskişehir'de Ermeniler tarafından kuruldu.
Çok enteresan değil mi? Şimdi bir tiyatro sahnesindeyiz ve bir onların kilisesi bir tiyatro binasına
gerçekten çok hüzün verici.
Sizce bu hoş bir şey mi Ermeniler için? Ne dersiniz?
Bu şöyle ifade edeyim. Bu aslında trajik bir şey. Yani aslında bir tarihi ironik bir şey.
This part of the city's history wasn't taught at my school. I decided to tackle İhsan Güneş, a professor of history who teaches at the university here in Eskişehir.
Eskişehir'de de Ermeniler yaşamışlar fakat bu bize pek anlatılmadı. Ders kitaplarında veya sözlü tarihte neden böyle sizce? Neden bilmeden büyüdük?
Niye yoktu? Bu şunun için yani Cumhuriyet milli bir devlet kurmuştur. Bütün insanları üst kimlikte yani Türkiye Cumhuriyeti yurttaşlığı kimliğinde birleştirmişti. Birinci Dünya Savaşı gibi oluk oluk insan kanının aktığı bir savaş. Ermeni unsurlardan yani Osmanlı'nın Ermeni halkından yardım almak istiyor. Onları kışkırtıyor. Dolayısıyla bu durum 1915 yılında Osmanlı yöneticilerini kendi güvenliklerini sağlayabilmek, yani askerlerini Kafkas cephesinde Rus ordusuyla çarpışan askerlerinin güvenliğini sağlayabilmek için Ermenileri ateş hattından, ordunun savaştığı bölgelerden alıp başka bir yere gönderme kararı alıyor. Ve bu karar çok tartışma yaratıyor.
Sizin görüşünüz soykırım olmadığı
yönünde. Kesinlikle bu yani bir tehcir olayı var. Ama bu tehcir olayı kesinlikle soykırım değildir.
I want to find out more about the Armenians of my town and what happened to them. Kemal takes me on a drive.
Şimdi, evet bu bölgede özellikle Ermenilerin yaşadığını görüyoruz. Yani kilisenin ve onun etrafındaki bölge. Ama bizim için önemli olan şimdi gideceğimiz yol boyunda böyle çok iyi Ermenilerin yaptığı iki katlı taş binalar var idi. Onlar hatta son dönemlere kadar bir kısmı varlığını devam ettirmişti. Fakat sonradan onlar yıkılıp yerlerine büyük apartmanlar, binalar yapıldı.
Peki el değiştirme nasıl olmuş?
Bu mallar, evler, arsalar, tarlalar Eskişehir'in zenginleri tarafından ucuz bir bedelle satın alındı. Her türlü işi yapmışlardır burada. Yani ekmek fırınından tutun da debahlığa kadar, demirciliğe kadar, duvar ustalığına kadar, kuyumculuğa kadar bütün meslekleri Ermeniler yerine getiriyor. Ki 4500 Ermeni yaşıyor burada, az değil. Ki o tarihlerde Eskişehir'in nüfusu 30.000'in biraz üzerinde.
Peki bu mahallelerde oturanlar sizce biliyorlar mıdır?
Ben hiç zannetmiyorum.
Anlatabilir misiniz? Ne oldu bu istasyonda 1915 yılında?
Şimdi bu demiryolu hattının Eskişehir Ermenileri için özel bir yeri var. Bu hatta Ermeniler çokça çalıştı. Yani Ermeni memurlar, Ermeni makinistler, kondöktörler burada bu hatta çalıştılar. Eskişehir'de Ermeni nüfusunun fazla olmasının bir nedeni de demiryolu. Şimdi burada 1915'te Ermeniler tehcir edilirken bu demiryolu hattı çoğunlukla kullanıldı. Eskişehir'de yaşayan Ermenilerin son durağı ve burada bu trenlere binip bir meçhule doğru, bir bilinmeze doğru gittiler açıkçası.
Armenians were deported and killed across the whole of Anatolia. From Van, I've come further west to the city of Mush. In 1915, just under half the population was Armenian. Today, the town is mainly Kurdish. There are new mosques, and the town has become increasingly conservative in its outlook and religious customs. Very few Armenian buildings remain. Murat Aktaş is a local professor of politics. We meet at the ruins of the Armenian San Marina Church. Look on this stone.
Yeah.
Exactly. Armenian signs, motifs. So when did the destruction happen?
I think in the last 30 years, treasure hunters were coming looking for the treasure, gold.
And nobody stopped them.
People were being encouraged. This was a good way to destroy all historical places.
Murat tells me that there is a historical Armenian site high up in the mountains.
We go to see Saint Karabet Monastery. It's one of the first Armenian monastery in the region.
Interesting weather.
Okay, yes.
So where's the monastery?
We will ask this guy.
Okay.
From the village. Hello, merhaba.
Merhaba.
Hello.
Merhaba, Jora. Du hazem ji kilise u ji monastery person. Tu zani li ku der bu deri vid krayem kurab harim ule.
Qasik mezi mezine qas sakir. Girişawi devir da bu.
Oh, wow, look.
It's like ticket.
Some Armenian writings on this. Wow.
Here is the door, yeah. Böyle.
Merhaba. The smell.
Evet.
Hello.
Yes.
O zaman tabii Birinci Dünya Savaşı'ndan sonra buraları boşanmış. Dünya Savaşı'ndan sonra buraları boş olmuş. Ruslar savaş olmuş, Ruslar geri çekmiş. Burası boş olmuş. Dedem gelmiş bu köye ile. Tabii zaten ne olmuş, olmuş. Yani bu ahullar eğer biz şimdiye kadar bakmasaydı bunlar şimdi çökmüştü.
But you know it's part of a church, it's part of a monastery.
Günahdır, ben de biliyorum yani kilise depodur. Anı için biz de günah değil, sonra biz sorduk bunlar da günah. Biz de biliyoruz kilise, hayvan bağlamak günah, affedersin tuvalet günah. Yani pislememek.
Now that you know it's part of a church, what are you going to do about it? Is it going to stay like this?
Yo, biz boşaltırız. Bak ben kendim elimde vardı, benim elimde. Benim elimde de ahur olarak ben kullanıyordum. Bana dedi, böyle de ben şimdi boş. Bu köy bizim millet fıkaredir. Devlet bunlara bir çare bulsun.
Monastery of St. Garabet. The site was founded in the early 4th century and was rumored to house the remains of John the Baptist. It housed a great library full of illuminated manuscripts. The monastery was burned and looted in 1915, and then later destroyed for its stones. Now, this is all that remains of a once magnificent building. I want to see if there are any hidden Armenians remaining in this Muslim town. In the back streets of Mush, I visit the newly opened Armenian Cultural Center. Its founder, Khairuddin Arslan, tells me how being born an Armenian means he has lived a life in fear.
Mush Soğuca köyde doğmuşum. 1958 doğumluyum. Çok belli bir baskılar vardı. Sonradan işte artık biz nereye gitseydik herkes bize Ermeni diyordu. Çocuğuna kızdığı zaman işte Ermenilik bir küfür olduğunu biz yavaş yavaş onu öğrendik işte. Bizim büyüklerimde biliyorsunuz kılıçtan geçen Ermeniler. Burada zaten Hristiyanlık olmadığı için yani zorunlu bir Müslüman olunmuş. Tarihten şimdiye kadar 1800 yıldır burada inşa edilmiş Ermeni milleti var. Demeden hepsini yok ettiler. Ve gerçekten şu da var. Yani soykırım demek böyle bir boş soykırım değildir. İnsanları diri diri kiliseye sokmuşlar. İnsanları diri diri ahıra sokmuşlar. Diri diri yakmışlar. Yani soykırım olduktan sonra biliyorsunuz bizim ne kadar güzel kızlarımız varsa, genlerimiz varsa belli insanları zorla almışlar. Mesela örneğin Güley, Miro'nun kızı Güley Harsetli. Veyahut da burada şu var, mesela derneği açtıktan sonra insanların çoğu geldi, işte bizim nenemiz sizdendir. Yani burada en az 10 bin, 15 bin Ermeni torunları var. Ermeni yeğenleri var, yani kesinlikle var.
Are there still fear for Armenians in Mush?
Evet, doğrudur. Mush'taki Ermeniler daha Cumhuriyet Caddesi'nden, yani derneğin burada olduğu dolayısıyla bazıları gelmiyor. Bazıları bu sokaktan bile geçmiyor. Biz buradaki Ermenileri bir çatı altında toplamak, korkunun ecele faydası olmamak ve gerçekten burada Ermeni milletinin varoluşunu gündeme getirmek, o Türkiye Cumhuriyeti'nde 2 yıl askerlik yapıyorsak, biz Türkiye Cumhuriyeti'nde eğer gerçekten vergi veriyorsak, bu Ermeni milletin tüm haklarını alacağız.
Thank you very much for sharing your story with me. I'm an Armenian, always lived outside, and I never thought coming here I would see this atmosphere and all these difficulties that Armenians, hidden Armenians, are facing.
Mr. Arslan wasn't the only person with Armenian roots who was happy to see me.
I can't believe you're making me an Armenian dinner.
Suslu is open about her Armenian ancestry.
Hiçbir şey söylemezdi. Nasıl geliyordu, anam zorla kelime kelime ağzından çıkarıyordu. O da söylerdi, anlatırdı. Dedi, bizi vurdular, dedi. Bizi şeyde, tarlada hani közüler varmış. Onların önündeymişler. Bir de bir kız kardeşim vardı, Menşe. Küçükmüş, o ondan küçükmüş. Babam demiş ki eve gelmesinler. Kaçsınlar evine, eve gelmesinler. Dedi, ben de kaçtım, kız kardeşim ardından geldi. Hani su kanalları var. Dedi, ben üstüne 2-3 tane vardı, ben üstüne geçtim, geldim. Dedi, ben şey, kız kardeşim dedi, geldi. Bir tanesine, üstüne önüne geçti. Diğerinin önünde kaldı. Artık dedi, geçti, kaldı, bilmiyorum. Hep onu merak ediyordu. Başka bir köye gider, kaçarak. Gider, bunlar o komşular ki götürdüler, baktılar. Orada evlenmiş, evlendirmişler onu. Bakmışlar, Allah razı olsun. Şimdi biz kimliğimiz, kimliğimiz Türk'tür. Daim gildi Türk, hani dedem Müslüman oldu. Dedem hani küçük ya, o aileyi ki götürdüler, baktılar, onlar Müslüman ettiler. Namaz, yani aramızda bir yaşadır, bir namazdır. Biz namaz kılıyoruz, Ermeniler kılmazlar. Bu kadar aramızda fark var. Ama herkes biliyor bizi, yani Ermeni olduk ne de, daim gibi biliyor. Saklanıyor, bir şey, diğerleri de herkes saklanıyor. Yok ya, böyle Ermeni değiliz. Müslümanız, çok şükür Müslümanız.
Part of the reason that Suslu is so open about her Armenian roots is that she has stayed a Muslim. And in her village, everyone already knew the story of her family. In Mush, there are a few Armenians beginning to talk, but Armenian culture and religion have all but disappeared. Istanbul, the largest city in Turkey, straddles the continents of Europe and Asia. It has a cosmopolitan outlook and is home to the largest remaining Armenian community in Turkey. The deputy patriarch here is Aram Ateşian.
Նախմեծ կգիտենք, որ մենք ասկային եկեղեցական համայնք ենք։ Ասկությունը եւ գրոնքը մեր կով իրար մեջ չեն կնազատել։ Երբ որ հայ գսես, քրիստոնյա կհասկանաս։ Եկեղեցին առաջ, որպես քրիստոնյա, ապրիլ զարկասած քաղաքներ մեջ ավելի ազատ է, Բոսոն մեջ։ Այսի կարավարտյան շրջանի, որ ազատություն կտան, գրոնքի ազատություն դրվեցավ, խոսելու արդահայտվելու ազատություն դրվեցավ մարդոց, և մեջտեղ ելան, ազատ օրեն առանց վախնալու ասելու, որ իմ արմատսա հայ է։ Բայց քավարի մեջ քիշմատի դարբեր է, որտեղ շատ քիշմ ավելի մոլերանտներ կան, քիշմ ասկային ամոններ կան, դակավին քավարի մեջ վախ ունին մարդիկը, բոլորը մեջտեղ ելար ու հայտարարել, որ ես քրիստոնյա եմ։ Մարդիկ վախով մեծած են հոտ, և դա կան այդ վախը չեն գցած վրան, իրենց վրայեն նետել։ Քրիստոնյա իսկ տարիվ կորզեն գնետենսելու վախ ունի։
I have also traveled to Istanbul, and I'm meeting Cengiz Aktar, one of an increasing number of Turkish academics willing to openly call the events of 1915 genocide. He believes religion is at the heart of the issue.
1915, it's a consequence of something. It's not the beginning of something. Actually, it's the end of something as far as the Armenians are concerned. It is the Islamization of those lands in order to create a nation state. And it continued afterwards with the Republic, actually, because in 1923, when the Republic was created, there were still many Christians left, the leftovers of the genocide, and they had to leave, and because their churches were destroyed, their schools were closed. Today, when we look at Turkey and compare it with the other countries in the region, including Iran, Turkey is the most homogeneously Muslim country of the whole region.
In our history, why didn't they teach us about Armenians?
I think it was compulsory to keep things in secret. The entire education system is designed so. Why would this state recognize its guilt? Why would it recognize its fault? All this ethnic cleansing, or religious cleansing actually, is at the foundation of the Turkish Republic. There was 2,538 churches, Armenian churches, in this country. Some 450 monasteries, almost 2,000 schools. Very, very few of them remain. I mean, they were blown up. This is why you never heard of Armenians in Eskişehir.
On the 100th anniversary of this issue,
What do you see the politics in Turkey?
Today, you know, unseen and unheard things are happening in Turkey. The last, I would say, 10-15 years. What remains of the churches are being restored. There are more and more books about the Armenian genocide. All these efforts of the state have failed. People are curious and they are, you know, searching for the truth. And the Turkish society, in that sense, is in a totally different wavelength than the Turkish state.
Here, there is evidence of Armenian culture. They held high positions in Ottoman society. For five generations in the 18th and 19th centuries, they designed and constructed many important buildings in Istanbul, including the Ortaköy Mosque. I'm visiting Zakaria Mildanoglu, a prominent Armenian architectural historian.
Ինչերձեր հայրիկի պատմությունը։
Իմ հայրս Յոզգացի է, գիտեք, Անադոլի մեջ նշանավոր քաղաքն է, որ բնակչության մեծ մասը հայերը գտազմի Յոզգացի է։ Յոթի եղբայրյան Իրմեզատունի 6 եղբայր, որ 1915-ին բոլորը հայրը, մայրը, իր բոլոր հասակները չարտված են Յոզգաթի մեջ։
Ապագան ինչպես եք տեսնում հայերի վիճակը այս երկրում։
Կացողները մեկ մաս արդեն կվերադառնան, սկսան կամաց-կամաց, 1, 2, 5, 10 հոգի վերադառնան։ Անորոշ Most bir daha birik, Türkiye meş bir daha birik. Ay sıkıntıların lüzumu bir de kıtlenk. Keşme bir de borak bir de gançenk ve dutyantem. Mer sıkıntıları asonker, mer iramukları asonker. Dövek ve ratatüsek mer iramukları. İnç var iramukunik. İnç av yere kazar yegiresi tıbrotsu. Uren asonk. İm babis Tunu Yozgat'ı meç Arder'ı gene gör kırbazı tapuğunu vera tapse kasok mezi yavaş yavaş bir daha bring yes huysunim.
There is no doubt that in Istanbul Armenians can openly practice their faith, but for many that is not enough. They are looking for recognition of what happened in 1915, and for some, that includes the restoration of their land. An 11-meter-high statue of Kemal Atatürk, the founder of the Turkish Republic, occupies a prominent position on Istanbul's Taksim Square. It's here that I meet up with Rengin again.
Hi, Rengin. Hi. How are you?
Welcome back. I'm all right. How are you?
I'm okay. Thank you very much.
How was your trip?
It was an eye-opener for me. First of all, on personal level, going back to Van, yeah, where my great-grandparents were living. When you talk about Armenians over there, I felt that it was 100 years ago, but it's still sort of fresh. Mm-hmm. The pain is fresh.
In Eskişehir, I also realized that people are open to remember this past. I saw that in a brochure in cultural center, they wrote this was an old Armenian church, and this is something important to let people know this fact.
Yeah. So maybe little by little, when these historical facts come out, it will be a small step to let both people start talking to each other.
Exactly. It's great to see you again.
You too. You too.
Have a nice time.
Bye. Bye-bye.
Now I look at Eskişehir with different eyes. When I'm walking through the streets, I will be remembering that Armenians lived here. I will look closer at the little of what remained after they were forced to leave. Now, I know they were here, as they were in every part of Anatolia.
I end my journey at Mount Ararat, back in eastern Turkey. Once part of the ancient Armenian kingdom, it remains a potent symbol of Armenian identity. It's 100 years since my family fled these lands. Despite the passing of time, I feel those terrible events of 1915 remain an open wound. I leave, hoping that one day that wound will heal.